Hey, welcome to the Danger Zone, it's Ashli. Everything in this video can be found on a public domain and the full disclaimer's down below. Lots of love and many blessings your way. Okay, this is really strange. Look at what I found earlier.
Your lifestyle and how you're living out there and so forth. Just a question. This is another set of six.
It is. Look, you managed to ask all the questions. It's normally that way. So let's have reverse roles. Just today. Now let me just reverse roles. Now you put your feet up and let me ask you some questions first of all. No. All right, listen. You've got to be fair. Now, let me just ask you, how are you enjoying it now in America?
This is where everything starts to get weird. I want you to listen very closely to the very next clip.
Now, in America.
Oh, okay. Loving it. It's fantastic.
Now, did you hear that? If not, listen again. Closely. With the volume up.
Oh, okay. Loving it.
Hear Meghan saying it's easy. He looks up and comes back with a dirty face and catches himself. He's trying to say everything she's telling him to say. She's clearly coaching him. Why? What is going on? You guys, she's obviously standing behind that computer because she's mouthing something to him and he totally forgets what he's supposed to say, which comes out of left field. He's meant to bring Archie's name up, and he acts as if he forgot that kid's name. Listen.
What I need is a few like mini rugby balls that I can then get Archie involved with the game, because at the moment it's impossible to find any.
He's been stammering. He can't even think straight. Like he doesn't know Jeff Bezos. Why don't he give Amazon a shot? They're loaded with mini rugby balls. After all, he wants to get Archie out there in the game. And the next thing he says is totally unnecessary. He talks about, hey, I've got plenty of room to run out here. We know Meghan, you're sitting on 8 acres almost.
But I've got a little bit of space outside, which we're fortunate enough to have. So I need to get him playing some rugby league. But I am just unbelievably fortunate and grateful to have outdoor space and see my son be able to be outside, because I know that so many people just haven't had that opportunity in the last 5 months. So our little man is our number one priority, but then our work after that is the second priority, and we're just doing everything we can to try and play our part in trying to make the world a better place.
I think that's really wonderful there, Harry, because I think it pleased me and you probably pleased a lot of people who probably will see this interview in regards to what you've just said about COVID and the difficulties in regards to the problems of space, people, and being able to associate and doing those basic things in life and everything. And you know,
we have to. All of us take so much for granted. And I think you know, some people said, "Oh, you know, COVID is a virus. Is something that doesn't discriminate between classes." It's like, no, I've spoken to people, and I know a lot of people who are stuck in, you know, high rise block of flats. They can't even see outdoor space. They can't even see grass. And I'm constantly aware of that, though it's not my environment. I'm constantly aware of it, and I think that is one thing that we all need to be really aware of. As these last 5 months really does play a huge part in the next 10, maybe 15 years as far as people's mental health is concerned. So this is why I think that the rugby league community and any community of people that have spent time together know what they're looking out for, because you may be fine, you may have a garden, you may have the space, you may be feeling, wow, this is really hard, but just to take that moment and go, if it's hard for me, how much harder must it be for other people as well?
I mean, obviously, we love having you here in England, and you've been a great supporter of our great game and everything, and the community of rugby league. And it's going to be great for you to come back. And we're hoping that you're going to come back and obviously grace us again with your
course.
It's going to be wonderful.
We've got a whole Rugby World Cup coming, Rugby League World Cup in next year. So, you know, I definitely plan on coming back. I would have been back already had it not been for COVID. So don't worry, you guys and the rugby league community will have my commitment for as long as I can give it to you, put that way.
it is more than obvious that he's being told exactly what to say, when to say it, in this entire Zoom call. And if you look at the people that are participating in the background, they're not buying it either. I can tell when he lies, he keeps looking away from the camera, and I'm not talking behind the computer at Meghan. He only does that when he's angry at her, and he gets mad at her several times throughout this Zoom call. When he came out and said, our little man's our first priority, he couldn't even believe what he was saying. His face was so screwed up. You ever seen somebody that lied? They couldn't help but make funny shapes with their mouth because it was so unnatural to them and their conscience. His mouth does this several times. He'll even look away from the camera so he doesn't feel as guilty for lying. At least he has a conscience somewhere. He made sure to say that work, their work, was the second biggest priority in their life. Number one, they have no work. They have no job. That's to convince people that they are working. Then he uses the excuse that COVID's going to cause a plethora of problems, mental health issues, for a good 10 to 15 years down the road. And what that does for him, what that does for them, it just strengthens their campaign trail. You know, they're on this mental health issue crusade, hot and heavy. He's trying to make sure, they're trying to make sure, that they have some sort of business endeavors in the mental health field for at least 10 to 15 years from now. Then she totally blows the fact that she's standing behind the camera, behind the computer. Her phone starts ringing and he is hot. He's so mad at her over this. Pure tea disgusted. Here's what I truly don't understand. For them to have moved to the States for privacy, they sure do get around. They sure do like the spotlight. I wanted to ask your opinion on something. My friend Holly sent me over this picture. You know, they had stopped in over at the preschool to plant some flowers with the kids. Now, around his neck, he's wearing something that reminds me of a talisman. And I was wondering if you're familiar with that. And if so, is it in your opinion that he's in fact wearing a talisman? That's what it reminds me of. I'm not going to lie. And looking at these pictures, Meghan just doesn't seem too thrilled to be there. But just like Lady C says, she's all about the column inches, all about those pictures in the press. I hope y'all are having a great day today. I'll see you soon and we'll talk fast. Please stay safe and be blessed.